If you've ever been confronted by an employee who says, "That's not my job," you know how tempting it is to pull out their job description and point to the line near the bottom that says, "Other duties as assigned." But that does nothing to improve morale or motivate effort. That's why in this episode of Your Practice Ain't Perfect, I'm going to give you a better way to respond to "That's not my job." Stick around. Instead of responding to "That's not my job" with debate or a directive, I want you to say, "Okay," and then ask this question: "What is your job?" And then wait. And here's what will happen. The employee will start describing their role. They'll mention their title and they'll tick off the job duties associated with their role. They'll say, "I was hired to blah, 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 blah." Let them go for a moment and then stop and say, "Okay, hold on. You're describing your role, and I'm very familiar with the tasks and responsibilities of your role, but I asked a different question. What's your job?" And then wait again. Now, in a perfect world, your employee would recognize what you're trying to do here and respond by restating your mission or describing the difference your work there makes in the lives of patients and families. For example, if you work in an oncology clinic, I want that employee to see their job as curing cancer and helping people move through it. If it's a cardiology practice, I want that employee to describe mending broken hearts, both literally and figuratively. Unless you've championed a powerful purpose like this, though, over and over again, that employee probably isn't going to give you that response. So now you have an opportunity to shine a light on the larger purpose of your work. And you can do so by saying something like this: "Look, I know that doing X isn't typically a part of your role, but everyone's job here is the same. It's to do whatever it takes to take care of our patients and families. That requires everybody to pitch in everywhere from time to time, and we don't keep score. That means that, yeah, some days you're going to have to do X. That's the job. So yes or no question, can you do the job?" This is a quick hit conversation. It happens in a hallway or off to the side somewhere. And while I prefer that this exchange happen one-on-one, you may have to do this in a huddle or at a meeting. However this conversation takes place, a good follow-up strategy is to offer to sit down and discuss any frustrations the employee has with the responsibilities of their job role at a later date. Now, one more thing. If this employee acts out often or frequently expresses these kinds of negative thoughts, then you may have a larger issue on your hands related to employee engagement. In such cases, you as the supervisor have to work through a series of steps to determine if this employee can be rehabilitated or must be removed. If you want help with that process, then grab a copy of my book, Cure for the Common Leader: What Physicians and Managers Must Do to Engage and Inspire Healthcare Teams, which is available on Amazon. So there you have it. When you hear, "That's not my job," ask, "Okay, what is your job?" And in the discussion that follows, acknowledge that yes, what's being asked typically isn't a part of their role, but it is a part of their job. Of course, that's not the only way to respond to that comment, so take a moment and let me know in the comments box below how you have responded to that terrible turn of phrase, "That's not my job." And if you want new episodes of this series delivered straight to your email inbox, then go right now to joemull.com and subscribe to my email newsletter. Take care and good luck out there.